Hey there, fellows. A new episode, a new curious experiment. Now, here's the premise. Someone suggested we remove the valve seals and the oil rings from the pistons to see how much oil the engine would consume without all of that, and how it would behave in general. Now, right here we've got this lovely car, which admittedly isn't new, and there is a bit of smoke coming from the tailpipe, which you're about to see for yourselves. Now, the point is to demonstrate why you need those components in the first place. The oil rings and valve seals, I mean. The theory should be pretty clear to everybody, but the practical aspect, well, I've never checked it for myself before. Now, I did used to own a very similar Lada, and that thing had a problem when the seals would pop out from the valve guides. I remember at least two of them doing that on the regular, and I was immediately able to tell by the exhaust gases and from the residue on the spark plugs. Now, right now, I suggest we start the car and see how it runs as is. Then we dismantle the whole thing. Well, I mean the upper portion of the engine. We do that and remove the valve seals to see what changes in the engine's behavior. And after that, we continue by removing the oil rings from the pistons. So yeah, we do that. And assuming the car is still able to run at that point, which it should, I reckon, though that amount of oil might not allow it to. In any case, we're gonna see how much more smoke it generates, how much worse it runs, or perhaps better. That we're going to determine during the course of this experiment. But for now, let's cough up some smoke, shall we? Let's do this. Fellas, I'd just like to say thank you for your support and for your kind words. I'm well now and everything's good. Now you yourselves take care, and make sure to take all of the necessary precautions given the situation we're in. Now the latest addition to our online shop are these lovely face masks that'll help keep you safe from all sorts of nasty infections. Now at the moment it's August and the rainy autumn season is right around the corner, meaning it's time to buy some warm clothing. We're offering you guys these fantastic hoodies from our shop, and as of recently we've also got these awesome vests for sale. On top of that we've got a bunch of other stuff, and we're always adding something new to the product line. For example, not too long ago, we began to offer these nifty lighters and air fresheners. So go ahead and give our online shop a visit. Get yourself some G54 merch. And when using the code from the video description, you can buy some stuff at a good discount. Okay, let's fire up the engine and assess the current situation. See how much smoke it generates. Let her rip. Well, there is a bit coming out. Give it some gas. Oh, now you can definitely see it. But for such an old car, that is totally normal. Absolutely nothing unusual there. Shut it off. And now we have a baseline. First, we're gonna remove the valve seals, which should result in some very drastic changes. It's gonna be dramatic. Though I don't know about the piston rings. I've never taken those off. Here's the situation. Two of them were already popped out, so two of them had evacuated. Give it some gas. Gas! Oh yeah, there is much more smoke. You can really tell. Give it some more. Oh, you can very easily tell. Hopefully it's coming through on camera. We've got a ton of extra smoke coming out. Can you shut it off? Now we let it sit after shutting it off. And there's your method for determining whether the valve seals are done or not.
20 minutes later.
Now, given that we are missing the valve seals, I'm sure some oil has dripped into the cylinders, which should result in a spectacular smoke show. Fire it up. That's what I'm talking about. When there's something wrong with the valve seals, the car can still drive without even smoking all that much. But then you leave it parked for the night. I'm sure a lot of people have seen it happen. When the car spits a bit of smoke out upon startup, that's the oil making it into the cylinders. And with 99% certainty, that's caused by bad valve seals. Right, so after removing those valve seals, we noticed that there's more smoke now. Give it some more gas. Yeah, that's a lot of smoke. Now I guess it's time to get the car onto a lift to make this more convenient. Then we remove the oil pan, the cylinder head, pluck the pistons out and take the oil rings off. Then we put everything back together, start the engine and see what comes next. Let's do this. We're about to get rid of these lower piston rings. Now that would be the oil ring. It's either going to be fitted with a spring or a noodle. It varies from one motor to the next. Now we pull all four pistons out, extract the lower piston rings, and throw it all back together. Let's get to it. Check this out, fellas. We've assembled the engine without any oil rings. Now we just need to... Yeah, we've got some fuel pumped in, that's good. Let her rip. Well, it started. Yo, man, did you top the oil off? Why is it running so loud? Did you forget to put the bearings back in? Are you sure you didn't stack one on top of another? That does happen. Man, what gives? Well, we do have oil. How is it that it wasn't knocking before and it is now? Can you explain that? That's a lot and nothing to worry about. I'm gonna go to the back and see how much more smoke comes out. We need to warm it up. It is obvious that it generates a bunch more smoke now, it does. Something tells me that after warm-up there's gonna be a ton of smoke. Okay, guys, it's quite obvious that it generates way more smoke. Now we pour in some coolant, get the car fully operational, and then it will be time to head out. Go for a drive and see what happens when the car gets out onto the open road. Let's do this. Right, fellas, so we just saw it smoking inside the garage. We decided not to drive around town as not to scare anybody, and instead we're at the test track, where we're free to smoke without scaring anybody, hopefully. Though there are student drivers roaming around. Then again, once they get out onto the roads, they're gonna witness a bunch of interesting stuff, so let's help them get acclimated. Okay, let's begin by checking the oil level. There we go. What do we see on the dipstick? Oh, somebody added a generous amount of oil. It's like 8 mil above the max mark. Now remember how much oil we got in there. Also, out of curiosity, I'd like to pull a spark plug out to assess its condition. I'd say the spark plug is in satisfactory condition. It is black though, meaning the mixture is off. But overall, it's okay. I'd like you to remember that as well. So it's all good. Now the plan is to travel about 50 kilometers around the test track. And then, after that, and bear in mind that I'm not going to be feathering the throttle. I'll be giving it some beans. Then I return to this very spot, and we see how much oil we've gone through, and have another look at the spark plug to verify its condition, whether it got any worse, though it might just be the same. We'll assess that after driving for 50 kilometers. Let's do this. Reset, and let's go. Oh, wow, have we got a ton of smoke back there. Holy cow! Looking into the rearview mirror, I can tell that driving around town would have been hella fun. That's what you get when the oil rings and valve seals are screwed. So we have traveled 1300, 1400 meters. Not bad, but we have to take this up to 50,000. There's gonna be a lot of driving done today. Aw, man, even when you let off, I can't see anything back there. Isn't that something? Incredible. Look at them plumes. Okay, fellas, so after going 10,600, I've gotten sick of driving. But I do have a few accomplices with me. All you have to do is drive. Just keep driving. Maybe rev the balls off the engine, create a lot of smoke. Make it so it looks as if there's a smoke grenade in the tailpipe. Don't let it get cold. We had to stop this. The reason behind that being, we're exactly at the halfway mark, at 25 kilometers, and maybe about 500 and something meters. Out of curiosity, I think it's time to check the oil level. It's all hot, of course, and hot oil is pretty quick to drip back down. Let's have a look. Oh, really? Now it's 8 millimeters below the max mark. It used to be about that much higher. We'll let it sit for another 30 seconds to allow some more oil to drip down. Though I don't think it's going to change much. When oil gets hot, it becomes pretty runny. So it's pretty fast to drip back down. Nope, still where it was. This has quite an appetite. Do we even have enough to go another 25 kilometers? It's hard to say, but we have to move out. Let's keep going. We are looking good, fellas. We're where we need to be. We've traveled precisely 50 kilometers, not counting the extra 14 meters. And now it's time for the control. To see what has happened. You would have seen the car smoking like crazy. And now it's time to see what's up. Okay, this looks pretty bad. Well, this is what we set out to prove. It went from maximum to minimum in 50 Ks. Like, for real? Oh, it burned through a bunch of oil. What's the difference between min and max in a lot of...
I can't remember.
Some engine builder you are. Then again, I don't know myself. Hopefully it's all in the oil pan. Yeah, look at that. A bit higher than the minimum. So 50Ks, and it drops down all the way. Let's just assume for a minute that the difference is 600 grams. This sort of situation is totally unacceptable. Look at that. Look at all that residue. It's as if it's covered in moss. Just imagine the amount of oil that has been processed by cylinders 1 and 2. And we've got a total of 4 cylinders. I mean, look at it. They are literally flaking off. The burnt oil deposits on the spark plug. Now, in theory, I'd say this spark plug, if it were to do another maybe 50 kilometers, I reckon it would simply no longer be in working condition after that. So there you go. Not every engine is going to be capable of dropping the oil level to the minimum in just 50Ks. But this one was very much able to. Then again, we were going pretty hard. And we were keeping the revs really high in order for it to consume as much oil as it can. Which is what it did over 50Ks. It went through a ton of oil. Okay, so we saw a dramatic decrease in the oil level. The spark plugs are now severely boned. But on top of that, you'd hear a lot of kind words from other drivers if you were to make it out onto the road. That's for sure. But we were at the test track. We didn't want to bother anybody, and so there was no swearing directed at us. And that's nice. As for the results, well, you saw it all for yourselves. And that's all I got for you. Watch us, subscribe, merch, give us a big thumbs up. The links are going to be down below. I'd catch you later.